Good afternoon, everybody. I am Dr. Mugdha Raut, a practicing obstetrician and gynecologist with special interest in the field of reproductive immunology. We have a center in Santa Cruz, Mumbai, India, called Dr. Raut Center for Reproductive Immunology, where along with my husband, Dr. Mohan Raut, we treat couples with unexplained infertility, unexplained IVF failures, and unexplained recurrent pregnancy loss with reproductive immunology, especially through lymphocyte immunization therapy and other immunomodulatory treatments. Let me start with the story today of Aastha and Shashank. Aastha and Shashank were waiting for me in the hospital. When I entered the hospital and upon seeing me, they both fell at my feet. I asked them, "What happened?" I knew they were going to go for a sonography today. When Aastha said, "Madam, for the first time, we were able to cross 5 weeks, 3 days. And today we saw our twin babies of 6 weeks each and heard the fetal hearts." They could not stop their tears of joy. I remember very well that Aastha and Shashank were referred to me by their gynecologist. The gynecologist had spoken to me that they have already undergone 5 IVF failures and 1 6 spontaneous pregnancy, all resulting in miscarriages. And now I'm going to send them to you. Everything is normal. I'm going to send them to you as a last resort. And that kept me wondering, is reproductive immunology a last resort? Is it just shifting a patient from one place to another, or is it a dumping ground? No, reproductive immunology is a science which could have helped Aastha and Shashank much earlier in their journey of reproductive failure. As we all know that unexplained infertility, unexplained IVF failures, or unexplained recurrent pregnancy losses have all the same reasons. There can be genetic causes, there can be anatomical causes, there can be hormonal reasons, there could be metabolic reasons, there could be blood clotting disorders or thrombophilias, there could be autoimmune disorders, and a large major of these causes could be due to the alloimmune factor. All these factors need to be investigated early on in couples with unexplained infertility, IVF failures, or repeated pregnancy losses. Just like we test them for the genetic factors, anatomical factors, and all the other factors, it is important that we test these couples even for the alloimmune cause much earlier in life, because we have to remember that all factors can coexist. Just like a genetic factor may be there, or the couple may be having a fibroid uterus, or there could be a problem with the sperms, they could also be having an implantation failure related to an alloimmune problem. And if the couple is treated with the alloimmune problem with lymphocyte immunization therapy early on in the pregnancy, it could save many years of physical, mental, and financial hardships to the couples. Aastha and Shashank began actually with unexplained infertility. Since all their factors were controlled and they were not conceiving, they were referred by their gynecologist to do IVF before they came to me. So the couple obviously thought, yes, IVF could be an option. So they went in for IVF. The first IVF, resulted in a beta HCG positive, the couple happy, the doctor happy, but yes, it resulted in no fetal hearts being seen and at 6 weeks and a miscarriage at 5.3 weeks. The couple obviously decided to go in for the second IVF. Again, the same sequence of events followed. The same thing followed for the third IVF. In the fourth IVF, the couple thought that let's go in for the donor egg. So they went in for the donor egg program using the husband's sperms. And again, sadly, it was the same story. The couple decided to take a break. And in that break period of 3 months, the couple conceived spontaneously. And again, sadly, this resulted in the same outcome. Now, Astha and Shashank thought that why should we look at something? We look at donor eggs and donor sperm. Let's go in for a donor embryo. So they went in for a donor embryo, thinking that their gametes were at fault. But again, though the IVF resulted in a beta HCG positive, it sadly resulted again in a pregnancy, no heartbeat seen, and the miscarriage of 5 weeks, 3 days. Now, when the couple came to me, I explained to them all the causes. I explained to them what alloimmune factor is, what reproductive immunology is, and how a baby is 50% mother and 50% father, and how immunology, immune system of the mother can reject the pregnancy, and an immunological memory is created which keeps on rejecting the pregnancy. The couple understood this immediately and they underwent all the investigations for reproductive immunology, for the alloimmune factor, and they always had certain questions. Is why should this be our last resort? Do I have any hope after this last resort, and will this work for me? The couple underwent lymphocyte immunization therapy at our center. 4 to 6 weeks later, the couple decided to try naturally. Unfortunately, they did not conceive, so they decided to go in for IVF. They conceived in the first cycle, and this was the outcome which I saw in the clinic that day. So the take-home message, friends, is think about reproductive immunology and alloimmune rejection of pregnancy early on in the case of reproductive failure. Always all factors may coexist. So just like you're undergoing a laparoscopy or a thyroid test, do undergo tests for alloimmune factor like HLA crossmatch and other tests which we can tell you early on. And please like, comment and share this video to as many people as possible, because you do not know who could be benefited from this video. And I would like to also give you our helpline number, 9833201522. 9833201522. Thank you all for a very patient hearing.